Where the river swings in channels wide, past Windsor walls in stately tide, where the bittern calls and the wild ducks glide, through rush and sedge and reed. Here lie the fields of high renown, where the Thames rolls by to London town, and Whitstone springs in sacred ground, the fields of Runnymede. Oh, braided in like beads of green, here islands float with the tide between, with willow silver glistening by rush and sedge and reed. And one of these, a place I know, where those who seek deep silence go, and roots reach down to long ago, in the fields of Runnymede. There stands a tree, but more than tree, beneath the dusky canopy, the home of runes and mystery, by rush and sedge and reed. And those who would true counsel seek, from far and near their journey make, to the ancient yew of Anchorwick, in the fields of Runnymede. To the ground where grows this hallowed tree, many hundred years a sanctuary, may come no trace of treachery by rush and sedge and reed. 'Tis a fitting place for the oath swearing, where the barons bold pressed John the King, to uphold the rights of all free men in the fields of Runnymede. So the barons of all England came, with little trust but sure of aim, the powers of the king to tame, by rush and sedge and reed. There is higher law than royal will, to the charter John must set his seal, and to earth new seeds of freedom fell, in the fields of Runnymede. Though islands float in the Thames no more, and ceaseless streams of traffic roar, yet there remains a place of awe, by rush and sedge and reed. It is earth's healing now we seek, from the roots of wisdom let him speak. O sacred yew of Anchorwick, in the fields of Runnymede. It is earth's healing now we seek, from the roots of wisdom let him speak. O sacred yew of Anchorwick, in the fields of Runnymede.